It's Friday night, and this is Friday Night Live at 5 with Kat at Kat's Creations. So, like always, I give it just a couple seconds between the time we go live and the time the first people start popping up to make sure that our sound quality is okay, that our video feed's okay, that our internet speed does not have any lag issues. But we're going to be making a April showers, rainy day umbrella wreath. So, is anyone there?
Yeah, there's 3 or 4 or 5 people jumping on right now, but I haven't seen them. Lindy's on.
Hi, Lindy. You've been on my mind all day today.
Yep. We're praying for you.
Yeah. Anybody else?
Give me a second.
Okay. He's pulling it up on his end. So, it was funny because I posted the signs that we had to choose from, this one and the black and white welcome sign with the roses. And when I posted the signs, people automatically assumed that they were supposed to vote on that particular post. Yeah, I was just giving you the signs between either one that we're voting on. So I was trying to tell everyone go over to the poll and vote. And then at some point, I actually took down our pinned post from Sunday night and pushed the poll up to the top so that everybody would vote. But I mean, it was a landslide from like the very beginning. So people wanted this.
So we have Lynn Hook said hello.
Hi, Lynn.
Jeanette. Lindy, of course, is on.
Hi, Jeanette.
Francis
Lindy.
Smith. Francis Smith Manzito is on.
Hi, Francis.
Ruby Plank is on.
Wait, Francis, aren't you on a road trip? I think I read that on my Facebook post that she's on a road trip taking some people to a cheerleading competition. So if you are, we're praying for safe travels for you guys there and back.
She said from New Caney, Texas.
Okay.
And then Gloria Maddox said, I'm here.
Hi, Gloria.
Cheryl Dunlop said, hello.
Hi, Cheryl.
Jeanette said, love the sign. And then Charlene said, hey, from West Virginia.
Hi, Charlene. Okay, so we're going to get going so that you guys obviously have other things to do on a Friday night. But this is our sign. Obviously, this came from Jane's Front Door Decor. Jane's signs are amazing, and she's constantly coming up with new designs. So she just came out some really cute wine signs, so you guys might want to check those out. It frustrates me because just when I place an order with Jane, she comes out with new designs, and then I have to reorder all over again. So this is one of them. It just says, let a smile be your umbrella on a rainy day. And we're hoping that we're supposed to get rain either late tonight into tomorrow. So that would definitely help. So this is my inspiration, and you guys always ask, where do I come up with my ideas for the sign? This one kind of threw me for a loop, even though I knew which two we were going to kind of be working on. I didn't really put this one together until this morning, and I knew I wanted yellow in it, and I knew, obviously, we're playing off of rain and sunshine. That was my inspiration. So I thought we'd mix it up with like 3 or 4 different shades of blue. A little bit of yellow, and then a little bit of white because there's so much white in the sign. So I'm choosing to not go with the red.
So Kathy Reinerston is on. She said, Steve, you missed me. I didn't. Just didn't have a chance to keep saying stuff. And then Marty Potts is on.
Hi, Marty.
Benita is on. Said, hey, from El Paso on a road trip
Benita.
To Georgia. And then Francis said, I'm in New Orleans. We were just getting cleaned up before heading to the French Quarter with cheerleaders in tow.
Okay, so I was right. So we're, like I said, we're praying that you guys get there and back okay.
And then Deborah Johnson said, hey, from West Virginia, or from Virginia.
Hi, Deborah.
And then Linda Schiff said, hello, nice sign. And Angie Martin said, hey, from Oklahoma.
Welcome, Linda and Angie. Okay, so we're moving on. So here's our sign. That was my inspiration. I'll show you guys ribbons in a little bit. Obviously, tools we're going to need is hole puncher, because I always ask for my signs when they come from Jane to be new holes so I can decide where I want to put them. So a set of hole punchers, these came from Amazon. These are Beadsmith 1.5 millimeter hole punch, and they'll punch up to 22 gauge metal. So they'll put the holes in your signs for you. Obviously wire cutters, scissors, potentially some wire, and one of these days I'll actually do a live and tell you what's all in my huge toolbox that I keep with me wherever I go. So we are going to start with a base of this high foil metallic blue. This came from Joann's at Christmas time. So when I was entering the SKU number on the materials list, You can't even order this. But you can go to like Craft Outlet or the Wreath Shop and look for a metallic foil blue. But, you know, you can pick and choose your own shades of blue. They don't have to be this blue. So, were you going to say something?
No, there's just more joining on.
Okay.
Valeria said, hey, from Tampa, Florida.
Hi, Valerie.
Shannon Brown said hello and loves the sign. And then Jeanette shared.
Thanks, Jeanette.
And a lot of people have actually jumped on, so.
Awesome. Okay. Well, if you're new here, let us know where you're from, and we welcome you to join us. This is our Friday Night Live in my kitchen, so I welcome you into my home every Friday night. So we're putting together an April Showers wreath. We're starting with our 14-inch wreath frame. On my private group, we actually did a work frame wreath, a 16-inch work frame wreath, and the pictures are from the Hello Easter sign that we did that's been on my Cat's Creations page. So we kind of showed them what the differences and challenges were in using a work wreath. And so everybody was asking me, why aren't you going back to your 14-inch flat? I was trying to show them what those challenges might be with the upper and lower rail. So back to our 14-inch Dollar Tree wreath frame. It has six sections that are separated by weld marks, just like that. And what I do is I put one pipe cleaner on
the inner
and that the next one up, so I call them rail one and rail two. So I'll put a pipe cleaner here, and then I'll put another pipe cleaner in the same section but on the outer rails, and I call them rail three and rail four. So this way, what happens is when you're putting your pipe cleaner on your two, like I am here, the inner and outer rail, it doesn't allow your pipe cleaner to slide. If you put it, I'll use the white or the yellow ones because they show up better in camera. If you just put it on a single rail, they just move. You can twist them with all the strength that you have in you and it won't matter. They'll just keep moving, which can be a challenge when you're trying to put your wreath together.
Hey, and Jane is on from Jane's Front Door Decor.
Awesome. Thank you, Jane. I can't wait to see what we decided to do with your sign today. And Jane is from Jane's Front Door Decor. So if you guys want to order signs, go through Jane. So
yep.
What we're doing here is we're going back in and we're adding to rail three and four. We're going to put another twist tie in this. And then I'm just toggling blue and yellow because these are my colors of my ribbons when I finish. So I just kind of one and two twists, and then this completes my wreath frame that I'm going to use tonight. So does anyone have any questions on Dollar Tree, 14-inch wreath frame, pipe cleaners, how to set it up before we move on?
No, we'll give them a chance to ask their questions right now. But
okay.
Rick Clyburn said, hey, Kat.
Hi, Rick.
Beverly Graber said, hey, from Ohio.
Hi, Beverly.
Cassie said, hey, from Iowa.
Hi, Cassie.
And then Cheryl Dunlap said, this is my first time watching from Colorado. She's excited.
Awesome.
And then Sandy Smith said, the mesh is perfect on my iPad. The mesh looks like there are drops of rain on them.
Awesome. That's the kind of effect that I was getting. And that's, if you look at the different shades of blue, I decided to go with this as my base. I was originally like toggling between, did I want to do a 21-inch poof method or did I want to do ruffles? And I know it sounds like I'm constantly doing the same thing, but our group and our private group just went over ruffles. So the reason why I didn't do ruffles this time is because I wanted things to lay lower on the wreath. When you do a 10-inch or an 8-inch or a bigger poof, you get height, you get volume, you get width. So I wanted to keep things very low to the ground so that when we add our ribbons or our florals, those aren't buried in the mesh, but they're laying where I want them to be.
So you are going to do ruffle?
I am doing ruffle.
Okay.
I'm not doing poof.
Gotcha. Yeah, you reversed it just a little while ago. You said you weren't going to do ruffle, but you are doing ruffle.
I am doing ruffle. I'm not doing poof because I want it to lay flatter.
And Jess is my question. Is there any rhyme or reason why you have the blue or yellow ties?
Yeah, because they match the blue and yellow ribbons that I'm going to be laying on the very top. And when you go to cut them off, they will blend. So obviously the yellow ribbons are going in where the yellow ties are and blue where blues are.
See, I knew you were going to say that. I just was leading you.
Okay, thanks for the leading question. All right, so we're doing 15-inch cuts, I believe, what I cut it to. Yeah, these are 15-inch pieces of 10-inch deco mesh. And like I said, you don't have to use this blue. You could do a 21-inch poof and just make it tall and poofy, like maybe a cloud, and then do different shades of blue, like a lighter blue and gray. Thought about that, but I'm picky about my grays because I don't want it to look like dirt, like a dirty white. I want it to be like a strong smoky gray. So we're ruffling. So to ruffle, you just take and pull your ruffles towards you. So we make little bow ties, and I'm gonna lay these face down sideways on the rails. So this edge will always point into the center. This edge will point to the outside. And it's just easier because if you start laying them sideways, like following your work frame wreath, you're gonna be laying them on top of one another. So it's easier for me to lay them sideways.
Yep. Lindy said, hey to Boba. And then Deborah Klaus said, hey from Pennsylvania. And Christine Martin said, hello from North Carolina.
Hi, Christine.
And then Gilda Scott said, good evening.
Linda, did you see Boba? Because he just now walked in the kitchen.
We heard her.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to just take these and I'm just going to go through and I'm going to ruffle these. This is going to create my base. And the reason why I chose 15 and not 10, not 12, not 14 is because I want that fullness and that thickness so that hopefully by the time I'm done putting all these on here, you won't see that black frame through all the mesh. And again, I want it to lay lower. So that's why I chose ruffles, not poofs.
Lindy said she heard him.
Oh, she heard him?
Yeah. And I think Vi is on.
Is she?
Yeah, it says Vi is watching. She just hadn't said anything yet.
Hi, Vi. How are you?
There's a Marlene Donahoe's watching.
Hi, Marlene. I know now I'm starting to get familiar with a lot of the names in my private group because we talk throughout the week. So getting to know you guys a little bit better.
So the 10-inch deco mesh is cut to 15-inch pieces.
Yes, 15 inches, just for the fullness. Because I want, like how they're rolled right now, I want that color blue to be apparent on my work wreath frame. So that's why I cut them to 15. So that I get that fullness of color and not, so let me unravel this one. I mean, you can still see it, but I like it when it's rolled. So I want that color, not so transparent. You're scooting by. So I'm just ruffling, and so I'm sticking. When you get closer to your roll, you guys know that it has a tendency of curling more on itself than is if you're doing a brand new roll.
If you guys have any questions, now's time to ask them as she's.
And this will take a little more than half of your roll. Because the rolls standard come in 30-foot rolls. So this is 18 pieces cut to 15 inches. So if you think about half of that, 15 at 15 is half of your roll. Right? No. Well, a little bit more.
A little more. Yeah, it'll probably be about 20, 24 feet.
So there's just a little bit left.
Jean Warren said hello.
Hi, Jean.
S said, hey, everyone.
Hi.
And Ruby shared. Thanks, Ruby, for sharing.
Thank you. Okay, so I have finished my inner six. So that's one in each section on my inners. And then there's 12 on the outside. So now I'm laying these in the outer sections. So we're scrunching like crazy. Are you trying to lick? Bye, Isaiah. Have a good drive to work.
Bye, you work.
Some people are just now starting their work day or work week. We're going all the way. the way around. And this would make such a cool beach wreath too. This color blue. I love the high foil. Because it looks like ocean water, like sparkly water.
Yep.
So I'm just going through and laying them face down between each of my two pipe cleaners and giving them one or two twists. Try to twist them in the same way so I don't untwist them when I go to put other stuff in. And it's starting to get thicker. You can see how close this one was to the very end.
Jane said, love the blue you're using.
Isn't that pretty?
And Diana Smith said, hey.
I have wanted to do a wreath for the longest time with just, I don't know, like...
blues.
Yeah, all different shades of blue, like a royal blue, a gray blue, this color blue, a silver blue. I just think it would look really pretty. But now I need to find the right sign and the right ribbon. And let me tell you, ribbon to go with this was a pain to find.
Well, I heard there's somebody on this video who could help you with the sign.
I know, Jane. Jane's been awesome. I think she's going to come out with some really cool beach. Well, I still have to pull down Jane's beach signs that I have. So I did order two from her, but we chose not to use those in the driftwood wreath, but they will definitely be incorporated in our summer wreaths. Yeah.
Jane's one that lives near Keene, right?
No, she lives up there. I want to say like in Taft. Kind of. A little higher, I think, than that, in Kern County. So not too far from us.
Yeah, Jackie's watching. She said that's a really pretty blue.
Thanks, Jackie. Jackie, who made the wreath with me last Sunday, Jackie?
Yeah, friend Jackie. Okay.
So we're almost done.
As Sharon said, she bought four signs from Jane today.
Woo, Jane's hooking it. Wait till you see her wine ones. If you haven't seen them yet, you have to check them out. Because she posted them this morning and then asked people to vote on which two looks we liked the best. And I voted on, I think it was like the darker, more wine-colored one. And then she had a light, like I would think of like white wine versus like a Merlot. And so she decided to make both. And then just a little while ago, she posted a really nice one that actually had like, it looks like grape wine in the glass, but it's all like wood grain around the side. And I was like, man, every time. I try to just wait and pile them up and then place one order. Because I just got my signs in from Jane. I haven't shared them all. Some. I think I shared the lobster one. And I shared...
That one unraveled a bit.
Yeah. It happens. Lobster and a welcome one, I think. She made some really awesome ones I can't wait to use for Memorial Day. 4th of July.
Did you use the wood burning tool?
Yes, I use the wood burning tool. So, if you guys want to see me do a couple demos of the wood burning tool, press the like button or the heart button right now.
Or just say yes, please show us.
Yeah. Well, I think it's easier if they just do hearts and likes. Can you watch? I know you're trying to follow Boba to make sure he don't get up.
Yes. Jackie asked, is this wreath going to give us the magical rain we need?
Oh, wouldn't it be that simple? This morning it didn't look like rain, but now it kind of looks like it might.
So there's a ton of thumbs up and hearts, so I'm assuming they want you to, yes.
Do the thing. Yeah, I can grab some of the deco mesh and do a couple cuts and show them how to do it. Let me put this one in, and then I'll plug the wood burning tool in so it could get hot.
Vi asked, have you ever made a poof wreath with 10-inch wreath? 10-inch mesh rather than 21-inch.
No.
If not, do you think it would work? Yeah, I don't.
I think I would have to go down in my work wreath frame because it's 14 inches. So, I don't know. You know, that would be a really good challenge to see if we could do it. But I would probably might want to go down to maybe a 10 or a 12-inch wreath.
Yeah, I don't think it'd give you the depth that you need.
Maybe
as
not.
As far as the thickness.
Okay, so this is what it looks like right now, just with the blue added in.
So
Let me plug the wood burning tool in. So that means coffee maker goes off. That's okay. So let me plug this in and add this. And it'll take a minute or two.
Couple minutes.
Yeah, to heat up. So while that's doing that, I can show you our next step, which is going to be taking, I have four different colors. So I have this lighter blue. It's not a high foil. This is a basic mesh from Hobby Lobby. I really don't like the consistency of this, which is why it makes for perfect curls. There's this really high foil mesh from Michaels. It's kind of like an ice blue, but I just like all the
colors.
That one
really matches the sign really well, though.
I know, right?
Yeah.
So my whole goal was just mixing and matching different blues. And then I have like really royal blue and a bright, bright blue, but they were just way too much. So we're going to incorporate those along with a white foil with the silver. And then here's our pop of sunshine. It's also pulling in the color of the rainbow. Because as we know, yeah, even though it's raining outside, sun's still shining above the cloud layer. So that was my inspiration, hence the blue and the yellow pipe cleaners. So let me do, we're doing curls. Can you grab my bow dabber?
Yeah.
It's on top of the deck of my track.
Sandy said she's gonna have to probably rewatch it because her sound is giving her problems.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sandy. You can try to reload it. This is what I do sometimes if I don't remember to bring my paper clip? Close in. Ah, I have some in my bag of tricks.
Magical bow dabber.
I know, I like the bow dabber better. When I'm not making bows, it's a curl holder. So I'm just gonna mix and match a couple different variations, and these are gonna go in every single one of the 18 pipe cleaners. So, like these two, I'll probably start. And as you can tell, the lighter or the silvery blue is a little bit longer. Michaels has a tendency of doing 10.5 inch deco mesh and not a true 10, but it won't really matter once we get him in.
It's funny, Ruby is driving, so she's listening instead of watching.
Hopefully she's not driving and watching slash listening.
No, she's driving slash listening, she said.
Okay.
So be careful, Ruby.
Yeah, that's the last thing I want to see. But I do it, but only if Steve's driving. And if we've got good Wi-Fi coverage. So now I'm doing... Yeah, now I'm doing white with some yellow. And what I did is these are all 10 inches, except for this like icy blue that's 10.5, but they're all cut to 10 inch pieces for the curls. And you don't need to go any bigger on the curls, because once you curl them, it creates that color you're looking for. So no need to do that. I guess I could take these out. Normally I just load my bow dabber with three different sets of colors, and then I'll go around and take them all out and wire them all in. So I'm just putting these in each one of my pipe cleaners.
So Anne Bashir said no poof. So just 15-inch ruffle.
15-inch ruffle.
For the main blue, yes.
Yeah.
And then all the others are cut to 10-inch, right?
Yeah. Can you bring me the wreath that we did in my group? I think it's hanging on the wall. I was trying to think where I put it. I try to incorporate my wreaths in my decorations when I'm not storing them. This one on this wall. I'll show you the difference between, and this is where you can decide poof. Do you want to do poof, or you do ruffle, or do you want to do curls? So that was poof, but I'll show you. This is the height right now with ruffle. Go ahead. And as you can see, the volume that you get with poof. So poof's going to create that big mound of fluff for you to build off of. So handy dandy ruler. I bought this because I need it sometimes when I'm going out. So this one's about 6 to 6.5 inches thick. So that's poof. So notice the volume. And it's really heavy. So I'm gonna give that back to Steve. And then this, now watch, it's all gonna stick. This is the volume. Even though you have some height with a little bit of the ruffles, you don't have the same height that you do. This one's like about 5 inches. So it took about 1.5 inches off. So that's a way you can tell, and either one will both fit in a 4-inch box for the duration of the shipping. It's not gonna do anything so extreme that your deco mesh won't pop back and it'll stay squished and flat.
Yeah, but I said she was thinking, because she was the one who asked about the poof or the 10-inch poof.
Right.
She was thinking maybe if she did two layers of it, she has a peacock ombre kind of color that she has an idea, but it's 10-inch. But you had the 21-inch, and that's kind of like a peacock. It had all the different really pretty colors.
Oh, no, but you should see the... Okay, and I think we're on the same path, too, because I did place an order from Craft Outlet that'll be here tomorrow, and I ordered a lot of the ombre colors, like ombre blues, ombre greens, so that I can mix and match with the blues that I already have. So is that why you're thinking poof over ruffle? That might look better?
For Vi, mm-hmm. I think she just wants to incorporate that color and make it a poof, so we'll see. Deanna Mustachio joined in a little while ago, said, hey, Kat and Steve.
Hi, Deanna.
She's the one who lives up in Fresno.
Oh, okay.
And then Darlene DeSario said, hey, Kat.
Hi, Darlene.
And Lily Gallardo said, I just got here late. Will there be a video I can watch the whole thing? Yes.
Absolutely. At we'll the post very this. End, yeah. We always post it as a replay. And yep. It'll stay up until... It stays pinned at the top of the Kat's Creations post until Sunday. And then we put Sunday's post at the top until next week, Friday, so you don't have to dig through all the other posts.
And it'll also go on her YouTube.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. If you don't want to dig through a bunch of stuff, you can just go to YouTube and look up Kat's Creations, and all my videos are there.
Yep.
And then you don't have to read everybody's comments that are popping through. Or I think if you swipe to the right or the left, it takes all the comments off, so you don't have to watch the comments go through your video.
And Diana said, hi, Kat.
Hi, Diana.
And Catherine said, hey, from Pennsylvania.
Wow. Thank you guys for joining.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm waiting for that. It turns like a funky color when it's hot enough. And that's what you want, hot enough to cut through that. And then we'll have to open up the back patio door. Because it does smell like burnt plastic, because that's what you're technically doing, is you're cauterizing your deco mesh. And I highly advise it, because you get less fray and less unraveling. Not so much from the cheap mesh, even though you cut it with a wood burning tool and you're cauterizing it. I think just the overall quality of it just isn't there to help that. So let me put one more of these in, and then we'll cut. I'm trying to think which one of these would show up better on camera with a glass. Probably the blue. Can you grab
the darker blue?
Yeah, one of the blue rolls that are open. So I'm trying to think of which one would look better for you to see on camera. Is it the cheapy stuff?
Yeah.
Maybe the yellow then. Because this one doesn't have a real clear line in it. So maybe the yellow or the white. We'll try it a couple times. And I'll have Steve zoom in on it really well so you can see what I'm doing. Okay. So let me set this aside. And let me grab the wood burning stuff. It only goes so far. So there's the downside of... Move this to the back.
But you can use an extension cord.
You can, but I don't like using an extension cord on things that generate heat. So, I'm going to take my board and slide it over. And this is why you want to get tempered glass. So, this is just a cutting board I picked up at Walmart. So, it's a 12-inch by 15-inch, and it has little grips on the side. So, what this does is it keeps it from sliding around all over the counter. But... if you can zoom in, Steve, you can actually still see all the lines through my tempered glass.
Yep.
So you want to make sure it's tempered glass and not glass.
We did.
So Walmart, I think it was $5.67 for this. And it has two different sides. It has your textured side, and it has your smooth side. So use the smooth side, obviously. Be very careful, because this is red hot to cauterize your deco mesh. So you can hold it like a pencil, but just be cautious about working around the front. I made the mistake one time of trying to position it, and I didn't quite get it right, because there's no real way, you know, it's not like a glue gun where there's an area to hold it. So,
yeah, so Diana, keep it this way. Diana and Kathy both asked, what is the brand of the wood burning tool?
You know what? I will look that up on Amazon and let you know.
It came as a kit. It doesn't have it on the handle. Oh, let me go look at the kit.
I have the kit right here, Steve. Maybe it's on here. It just says wood burning and soldering, but let me look at the instructions and see if it has a name on here. No, just what's included and how to change out your tips. All it just says is full set wood burning stand and carry case, but there is no stand. I will have him look at that on Amazon. There's nothing on here. Like, zip. It just says 110 volt, 30 watt, and it just has a little light on it.
Okay.
But I know it's like 23 something, so he can pull up our Amazon orders and look and see what the brand is. So, in order to cut this, it's different than if we were cutting regular deco mesh. So I'm going to take this.
Our regulars are chatting with each other. It's funny.
It's okay. I love that. I love that even when my group does it in our private group. I'm like,
yeah.
Knock yourself
out. Catherine, Peggy, and Don are saying, oh, I'm from Nanticoke. I'm from Tamaqua. I'm from Scranton.
I think it's great that if you guys can get together based on where you're located and you guys form your own like little wreath-making group and go out on shopping sprees or, who knows, go to a wreath-making convention, wreath-making show. I think it's awesome. Okay, so when technically we're laying this out to cut and we're going to do a 10-inch piece, I have my cutting board set right here on the 14-inch line, and here's 24 inches, which would be 10 inches. When you're using your wire cutters, you just follow your line and you just cut. Doesn't matter. If you ever notice on your deco mesh, it kind of has a little wavy effect to it. So when you're using the wood burning tool, you find your 10-inch mark, and then you're going to go through the very small little boxes, and you're going to stay in that entire channel, regardless of how it goes, all the way through. Because even when we're cutting it, we're not cutting it ideally straight, because the lines will all move. So I'll have Steve zoom in. I know you're looking at the wood burning tool.
Yes.
So can you zoom in? So they can
see. It's still zoomed in.
It's all the way? Like as much as you can so they can actually see the little grid lines?
Okay, it is now.
Okay, if you let it get hot enough, it will be so hot that it's going to melt, and you could technically just drag it right down like a knife through butter, but you're gonna want to stay in your little channel. So here's my 24. So I just set it here and I draw a line, and I'm following that line regardless of how it looks all the way down to the end. Oop, I want my coffee thing. And technically what it does is it makes a straight cut. Our rotary cutters don't cut it straight. It just cuts it straight up the line. And I don't know if you guys have ever noticed that when you're pulling your deco mesh up, all those individual little woven lines are always moving. They're kind of going in and out. What are you looking for? Are you looking for the little holder? But wouldn't that get hot? He made me like a wooden holder to put this in, and it started to wood burn through the hole. Not like burning through, it just started, I don't know, it smelled like burnt wood. Mm-hmm. But as you guys can tell, it cuts it perfectly. So you actually have a legitimately straight piece. So, and it does it really quick. So again, you just make sure you're right on your line. And I just try to keep my bottom and my top line straight, because it doesn't matter if you look at your deco mesh, it goes in and out. So again, you just pick your starting line at 24 inches and follow your line all the way down. Just like so. And as you guys can see, it smokes a little bit, but it's not horrible. And it's not like, you can pick it up right away. It's not like it's burning hot on the end because it's still melted rubber, but it cauterizes all those frayed pieces together. So do you guys have any other questions about the wood burning tool? The tip that I'm using on here, I don't know if you guys can kind of see it, I'm trying to kind of hold it this way. It looks like a,
so I gotta zoom
like
in.
A chiseled pin point. I'm not gonna touch it because it's still on.
Yeah.
But it's kind of angled.
Yeah, I can see it.
And then it's pointed even this way.
Mm-hmm.
If I hold it this way, it's like a knife. So I'm just sliding it down that deco mesh.
It's almost like a calligraphy pen, but not as
yeah,
pointed.
But it'd be like a, yeah, exactly, almost like a calligraphy pen because it's kind of got a diagonal edge.
Right.
But I like it because it's got that cut, so I just kind of drag it down the glass.
Yeah.
So any other questions you guys have?
Nope. So the wood burning tool is made by Athomy, A-T-H-O-M-Y.
Okay.
$18.99 on Amazon.
Oh, it's only $18?
$18.99.
I got the kit, though. It's $23. Are you sure? Or you're just looking this one up?
I looked at our order.
Oh. Well, they must have dropped the price because it was $23-something. So I'm going to move these back out of my way so I don't inadvertently. Burn the edges of my, and then it came with all this stuff in it.
Yeah,
so like all the tips, the little stand that Steve now showed me, and then it's got like an ironing, like a flat tip for actual wood burning as well. So it's 28 pieces, and it came in a little zipper pouch.
Yep.
Along with that tool. So definitely handy to have. I am starting to notice in working with deco mesh that it doesn't have as much fray. I think I showed everybody when we did it the last time, I had very little debris left from that.
Yeah.
The stuff that I'm picking up now is just that foil that's popping back out of these. So let me go back through and curl these again. So we can finish these. What do you guys think of the wood burning tool? Do you guys like it? And you'll get faster. It's just, I don't know, I'm kind of a perfectionist, so I want my lines to stay in the middle. So I just take my time. And I'm older now, so it takes me a while to kind of focus on each one of those little squares and make sure that I'm keeping it in the line. But it definitely looks nicer because you don't have all those frayed pieces sticking up everywhere. So I just do my two twists.
Verlene jumped on and said, "Hey Kat, I can't stay, but wanted to say hello and I love your lives."
Thank you. Feel free to come back.
Yep. It'll be replayed later.
Yep.
And then Charlene said, "Used my husband's wood burning tool today and she loves it."
Oh, awesome. See? We're borrowing, what did you call it? The whole wives borrowing their husband's tools.
Yeah.
You actually had a term for it, I think.
Oh.
Was there a term?
Yeah, I don't remember what it was. It was like borrow with a permanent attempt or a request to keep or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah. Like my staple gun and the tape gun. I think those are really the only tools I've inherited and I haven't put back. Because my tape gun for packing and then staple gun. You never use a staple gun except for Christmas, putting up the lights.
Yeah.
That's it. So I'm going to borrow it all the other times. Now I'm just pulling all my pipe cleaners back through, going around the bottom. See, this is already looking like I'm already seeing ocean. Maybe I'm just like anticipating summer.
Yeah.
Because
Bernie said, I always learn so much from you.
Thank you.
And then Diana said, hey, she can't wait to try it. Just got her craft outlet order today.
Ooh.
It's like, so, like Christmas, huh?
It is so much fun.
Lindy said appropriating. Maybe that was the term I used. Appropriating. I don't know.
That doesn't sound like a term Steve would use. But it sounds like a really awesome term that we would use.
And then there's a Susan Hawkins Denard that said, hey, from Houston.
Hi, Susan.
First time on live with you.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching and joining.
Absolutely. We are making a April showers wreath.
It's better than the Olympics.
Why? The Olympics are over, aren't they?
Yeah, they were kind of boring this year.
I didn't watch any. I'm not a real big TV watcher. Probably because I make wreaths during the day, and then at night I read. So, I've been a book reviewer since 2009. So I read.
How many books have you said you reviewed?
What did I say? I read this so far since 2009. Like, I used to read 1 year I read over 365 books in a year. But I've been a book lover from the very beginning. These are different colors. I'm thinking I'm mixing them. Since I was a child, that's what I did all summer long. You know, before video games and everything else, I would spend my Saturdays at the bookmobile because the library was too far.
Yeah, but I think you said just in the last 3 or 4 years, you've read like 1,600 books.
Yeah, 1,700.
Yeah.
But all the things I've learned, not really. Mostly, I think my favorite genre right now is, I like World War II romance. With World War II as the setting. That's about my favorite.
And there's a Denise Boblett that said, hey, from Kentucky, first time watching as well. Love reading too.
Hi, Denise.
And then Catherine said, I thought it was just me. She wasn't really into the Olympics either this year.
I wasn't either. I just figured if it was something major that happened, we would see highlights of it wherever we needed to. But, I don't know, time's such a precious commodity now.
I just thought, how could you have the Olympics at a place that has almost no snow?
It's always been like that, though, for most of the Winter Olympics.
Oh, no, been. Most of the time they have places where they have a lot of snow.
Where did they do it this year?
South Korea.
Seoul, South Korea. I thought there was a place that they did it that didn't have snow either. I don't know. I used to be a huge Winter Olympics fan. But
yep, that was too political.
Now I'm just too busy. Wreath maker by day, book reader by night.
And there's where you can use your bow dabber as another.
Yeah, it's a curl holder.
Hand helper. Helping hand.
See, watch, I'll just load these. This is normally what I will do. I'll just sit here and load them. So I have three done, and then I'll just pull them all out and put them in one by one. So just curls, curls, curls. And for me, it doesn't matter if I do one color on top or the other, because I'm going to put bows on the top, so you're not going to see which one was on top versus which one was on the bottom, because they kind of pop up on their own. And I lay them in like a X pattern so that I have one color on one side and the other color on the other side. Yeah, I'm doing them right. Yeah. I cut them correctly. It was like 9 of each 4 colors.
You guys have any questions so far? So the curl mesh is cut to 10 inch.
Mm-hmm. Everything's cut to 10 for the curls.
And the original base, the deeper blue,
is cut to 15.
It's a 10 inch cut to 15.
Mm-hmm.
10 inch mesh cut to 15 inches.
Yeah. I know someone posed a good question the other day. They asked if there's anything else besides the poof method that you could use 21 inch mesh for. And for now, I know that you could use the poof method for that because it works really well. It covers really well because it's so long and so thick, But I know that there's a way that you can do a curl on a 21-inch mesh. So you roll it just like a curl. It'd be a big curl. And then you take it like the ribbons for like breast cancer or whatever, and how they do the little ribbon. You would make that, and then you would put that in there. So it would have a loop and then two tails. I've seen that before. Okay, so I am done with my exterior.
Oh, that'd be good. Kathy and Nat just said, would you ever do a wreath with a coffee theme?
Yeah.
So a coffee or a tea as well.
I just have to find the... I'm always about the embellishments.
Yeah.
Like, what could I use? Okay, the sign's a given. We could find the signs all day long. But it's like, what would your embellishment be? Like, because you couldn't really put a coffee mug in there. Because it's weight, right? We try not to use anything that's breakable.
Our whole kitchen is coffee themed.
Pretty much. Kind of barista. Yeah. And I did that one. So, yeah, I'm down to my last ones. So I'm rolling these as quick as I can. This one, yellow.
Yeah, you could do them. Nancy said you could use them as like an awareness ribbon.
Yeah.
The 21-inch.
You can.
Especially if you're in a pink. Yeah.
I think you could go like every other one, because I know the 12 on the bottom, two of them kind of get close to each other, but you could do that every other one.
Yeah.
It would look good.
And Jane said, love that you added the yellow in there.
You needed the yellow.
Yeah.
It has to go with the sign. But at Craft Outlet, they have these really super cute tin umbrellas, and they come in green, yellow, red, and blue. So, of course, when I decided to do this theme, I didn't have the yellow, I didn't have the green, I didn't have the red, but I have the blue. So we're trying to decide if we're gonna put it in here. I'd like to, but it's very high, so we'll have to see if we can get it to fit.
It's wide, yeah.
Yeah, it's tall, so it would mean that it would have to go in a 6-inch tall box and not a 4-inch tall wreath box to be shipped out. I don't know if I put those two together. I needed to skip them. Skip, and it goes over here because I just did those two. So I'm just mixing up the colors, white and yellow, and then the two blues. So I put the two blues there. So it wasn't looking very organized, equal, balanced, like Steve likes it. Oh, and I have one on the ground. Okay, yellow and white. And then we will go in and we'll add our sign. And I'll show you guys how we pop our hole on our sign. It's really easy. So my thing is to get a little storage box, and I just keep all of my supplies in it. Like my scissors, my fabric, though a cutter wheel. There's the other one. Try to find the other end of my pipe cleaner. Yep, I know, I hear you. Don't think about it. Keep badness in check. Keep it in check, buddy. He's just a cat who loves attention. So when we ignore him, he comes and seeks out attention from us. And then, of course, when we want attention from him, he wants nothing to do with us.
I have him, so he's watching your live video on the phone.
Oh, that's funny. Okay, this one goes here. So I have one more to go, and then we are done, and I'll show you what this looks like. So again, I'm just putting these in and twisting them like two times. And you guys can see I still have a lot of twist tie left. So I'm not opening these up and adding them to the ruffle. I'm just adding them to the pipe cleaner on top of the ruffle. There's no need to open it up because there's plenty of pipe cleaner there. And this one, down on the floor. So if I was literally doing this myself, I'd be cutting them one at a time, just like these, and then putting them in. Here's my last one.
There's a Carol Solis who just joined. She said, hey, from Southern Indiana.
Hi, Carol. Okay, we are all technically done. So this is what it looks like. It reminds me of Nemo. I don't know why. It's like Dory colors.
It's like coral.
Yeah. It looks like Dory. Like blue, like blue and white and blues. So this is it. And then we have our sign. So now our sign will go in the middle of this. And now it's funny because it's like the red kind of sticks out. But I think once we add some other stuff, we're going to kind of, I mean, when I'm picking ribbon colors, I would not pick black, white, blue, red, yellow, and then go with those. I just kind of pick three. So in my group, I always teach, like, you can go shades of blue to get additional layers of depth to your color. And then I just went with the yellow and white. What?
Lindy's got cats, too. She's sitting. All her cats love crafts. When they see you going toward the door, they scream in like a bullet.
For some reason, he likes the texture of the deco mesh. I don't know why. It's weird.
Yep, and then Denise asked where we're from.
We are in Southern California, in the high desert, in Victorville, which most people have no clue where that is. I always tell people it's halfway between Los Angeles and Las Vegas. So we're like on the way to Vegas. We're one of those small towns that two exits and then the town's gone.
No, it's not two exits. It's 10. What are you talking about?
It's not 10. Yeah. You're counting all the little, like Hesperia, Oak Hills, Apple Valley. Okay, so here's our sign. I've attached my business card to the back. So I tell you, it's a good tip to do if you have business cards. This way your customer has that handy. In the event they want to reorder from you, all your information is conveniently located on the back of their sign. So,
Barb said, hey, from Utah, she just joined.
Thanks, Barb. So we're going to take our hole punch and we're going to punch our holes in our sign. So I'm going to put them on either end. Now, when you order your signs from Jane, you can get your signs put on the sides. The hole's already done. You can get them done on the top and the bottom. No holes or holes all the way around.
On the corners, yeah.
Well, no, not on the corners. Here, 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 and here.
Right.
Not on the corners. And then, or no holes. So I like them no holes so I can put them where I want them to be. So I'm going about halfway. So it's just like a hole punch. Literally, there's like no effort there. And yeah, Steve showed me this, that if you kind of rock it back and forth, you can make the hole just a little bit bigger. So I know you guys can't see it. But it is actually big enough for a pipe cleaner to go through. So, I'm going my umbrella.
And then there's a Denise Estrada. I said, hey, from Riverside, California.
Hey, Denise. Trying to get some local people to get together so you can make a SoCal wreath group. That would be awesome. Okay, so I'm thinking I want blue. And sometimes I look at what color do I want on my sign, even though I'm not really gonna see it, I think I wanna lean more towards the blue than the yellow, because the yellow really stands out. The blue does too, but not so much so. So it just goes right there, sign, just like that.
So Nancy Donahue's, you said, who makes your signs?
Jane's Front Door Decor.
And if you look about 10 posts up above, it's Jane's Front Door Decor.
Yeah.
You can find her on Etsy.
Yeah, she has her own Etsy store. She has her own website now. And I need another blue one.
And you can follow her on Facebook.
Yeah.
That's where you can find her from.
Because she always posts all her new products on her Facebook page. And she'll ask people's opinion. Like, I know she's starting to get ready to roll out her summer signs. So she'll always ask you know, what do you guys want to see, you know, for your summer? So I just put them in, do a couple twists, just like so. This is what it looks like from the front, but I'm not really worried about this. This is the least of my worries. So I'm not looking for perfection. And then you kind of just eyeball it, you look at your wreath, and you kind of like, is there a bald spot somewhere where the sign would kind of look more at home, I guess? And I'm liking it.
Marie Crafts said, hey, from Florida.
Hey.
And Carol Borgalt said, hey, she had company, but she made it before we ended. Yes, she did.
Oh, very cool. So now we're going to take our pipe cleaners. We're going to feed them through the deco mesh to the underside of our wreath frame. And I'll show you what that looks like when I flip it over. So I usually keep my hand underneath, so when I poke it, I can feel it and then pull it. So here is my twist ties. So I have one above and below the rail. So I'm just going to kind of push this guy over a little bit more.
Thank you for sharing, Carol. If you guys could all share, that would be appreciated.
Sharing isn't so much for me. It's for you guys, because then you guys have this video on your page anytime you want.
Rosemary Fabineau said, howdy, Kat.
Hey, Rosemary. So again, I just keep my hand under there to make sure that I'm going through the rails. And this deco mesh is so nice because it just literally pops right through. So I have it here, and I want it to go on the other side of that weld just to give it some extra structure and support. So it's like right there. So now I'm going to take it, kind of twist it. Then I'll flip it back over and look at it, because right now it seems like it's bowed. But you just push it down. And then what I like to do is all those lovely little curls that you stuck under there, I like to bring them back up to the other side. And the ruffles are still under there to keep our sign balanced.
It gives it a good base.
Huh?
But it gives it a good base.
It does. And I like the colors, so I'm pulling them out, like so. And those guys came out. There's four there. There's four there. And I got them all out. So, you can kind of play with these and move them away from your sign, but that's now what it looks like with our sign inside.
Yeah, looks good. Okay. Just because you have a little bit of red doesn't mean you should add red to it, because if it doesn't match the wreath, no, you don't need to add it. As long as it has three or four main colors.
Yeah, I'm not worried about that.
The red looks good on the sign, but yeah, you don't necessarily need it on the wreath.
Imagine if you tried to incorporate that somewhere in here. I think it would really, I don't know, it would almost seem like you're trying too hard to match everything in your sign.
Yeah.
And I'm not adding the black, even though the lettering is black. I'm just picking those three neutral colors. So this is what I figured we would do. I already pre-cut my ribbon tails. So I have that sunny yellow that matches the same. This one actually is yellow with the cream through it. So this is the gingham with the white through it. And then I did blue polka dots to play off of like the little raindrops in the sign. Even though they're polka dots, they're not raindrops. It'd be really hard to find raindrop ribbon. So we're going to put those in, and then I also have, even though this doesn't look yellow, it is, and then I have flex tubing that's in blue. So in my wreath group, what I teach, if before you begin cutting and everything, if you're unsure of your color choices, do a mock-up, which means make a baby sample. So what I did is I took my wire wreath frame. I have ones that are just sitting in there for samples. And I cut my deco mesh that I was going to lay down. And then I started playing with the different colors. Like, I put the two different color blues in. Then I put the blue with white. I added little ribbon tails. I added I figured if I went with a blue ribbon, I would add a yellow deco mesh tube to it. And then we also looked at, because April showers bring May flowers, we thought we could even add some blue shades of blue tulips, or we can add some blue and yellow daisies in this as well to kind of tie that all together, so it's not just April showers or a rainy day wreath. It's kind of like that transition from spring to summer. So we have those.
So tulips and daisies make to daisy.
Okay. Anyway, so this is what I always teach my group. Mock up, because then really all you're wasting, one ribbon, one curl or two curls, and then your bottom. And then if you decide to go with this, you're already one step of ahead, because you already have this one laid out. So you're just gonna do the same thing, but you're gonna toggle every other one. So it kind of helps you go, yeah, I like the way that looks. Now I can carve into my rolls of deco mesh. Okay, my glue gun is plugged in just for that. So I wanna make sure that was there. So because we're toggling every other one, I'm going to, on the yellow deco mesh curls, I'm gonna lay the blue, and on the blue, I'm laying down the yellow. So that one is yellow and white. So I'm going to lay this in. So in order to get middle ground, if we fold our ribbons in half, it gives us that halfway point. So it should look like this. I always told people it looks like a little bird flying from, like, when we drew birds in grade school. That's what birds look like.
Yeah.
And then you just pinch the edges, or pinch the middle, and then you lay it inside. You don't have to undo your pipe cleaner again.
Tammy, hope you're okay. She said, sorry, I'm late. Just burned herself. Tammy Pinkston, not neighbor Tammy. She said that's really pretty colors together.
Thank you. Yeah, I hope you're okay and that it's not a bad burn. And then we're taking this, doing the same thing. So I know we have first timers here. Do you guys need to know how to make the perfect dovetail cut? If you do, can you throw some likes or some little hearts on the icon? And then I can stop and show you how to cut these so that you can get this perfect cut and not do it the way that we all did before we learned how to do this, which was cutting this way and cutting this way and hoping that when they met in the middle, we would have a fairly equal cut. So let me know.
Yeah, there's about four or five people who thumbs up it.
Okay, well, let me do it. I'll do it a couple times so you guys know. I know Jackie was super excited. She goes, why didn't I know that technique before Christmas? Then all my ribbons would have looked so much nicer. Okay, so let me grab some ribbon. So this is the way the yellow ribbon comes from Craft Outlet. It comes in a 50-yard roll, and I have barely dented this. So to do a dovetail cut, the perfect cut, your ribbon should come with wire. It makes it so much easier to use ribbon that's wired than if it's non-wired. So you're going to take your two edges and fold them together, just like so. You're going to take your scissors and you're going to cut from the folded side to the point, or to the edge of your ribbon.
On a 45-degree angle.
Yep, just like that. And then you have a perfect dovetail.
Easy peasy.
Now, if you forget and you fold them in half and you forget which end to cut on, always keep telling yourself folded side first. Let's say we cut from the metal to the point of our fold, you get an arrow. You get like a little point.
Yep.
So obviously that tells you you did it wrong. So just remember.
Cut from the fold.
Yeah, fold your edges together. Cut from your fold all the way to the point of the edge of your ribbon. And you don't have to go like way down here to get a good point, because that would just be like an insane, but I don't know, about half.
45 degrees. Yep.
Yeah, just that way.
Yep.
Yeah, because that was Jackie. Jackie was like, how far down do I cut? And I was like, Lord, you don't want to go too far. I mean, you don't want to go like, I don't know what that would be, like a 90? I don't even think you can hold it that long. I'm trying that one. You'd have a really long dovetail, and that's like, you don't want to see that on your ribbon. So, okay, hopefully that helps you guys. So back to my blue. So these have all been dovetail cut, because it just makes it easier, and I'm just going around and adding these to the outside of my pipe cleaners for now. I'm not sure I want to add them to the inside just yet, because our sign covers quite a bit. So we might not even really be able to get a ribbon underneath that. So we'll go with the ones that we can see. And that is blue here. So I'm doing blue with my yellows. Just to give it the opposite effect. And then yellow. Nope, need blue with yellow. Oh, I know where it's at. It's underneath the other one. Could see the one that's here. I was like, why do I have three yellow all together? But the blue's hiding. And we'll fluff our ribbons later. But that's the nice thing too about using wired ribbon is it's so easy to fluff. It's hiding under the yellow. And I think this just ties in that yellow polka dot. It ties in the raindrops. I don't even know, even if you wanted to play off that red, like what you would use. I just think the colors are so...
I think it's okay for it to just be on the side. It looks good.
Oh, yeah. Looks good. But I'm just saying, even if I think you wanted to.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you'd have to take the yellow out. I just don't see yellow, red, and blue on a wreath together. I think that's
not
just...
Not for a ribbon. Yeah.
It's too much.
Yeah.
So there's our yellow. That one's underneath. Here's blue. So as you guys can see, I'm just taking these.
And the 1.5-inch ribbon is cut to what size?
10 inches.
10 inches.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody asked me a question today about ribbon tails. I think they were making a wreath, and I want to say it was Marlene, but I'm not sure, about ribbon tails and how long should they be cut. And the first question I asked her is, are you doing a poof? Are you doing a ruffle? Are you doing a curl? Because I need to know depth. And I think she said, I haven't decided yet, poof or ruffle, both maybe. So I said, cut one ribbon, just one, to 10 inches, put it inside your curls or your ruffles or your poofs and see if it comes, if it extends out far enough for you. If that was the look that you're going for. If it is, then cut the rest of your ribbon to 10 inches. If it's not, and it's like just barely sticking up out of your ruffle, and maybe all you're seeing is like this, then cut it to 12 or 14 inches.
Or you could cut your sample to 12, and that way if it's too long, you can cut it down.
Yeah, again, having a mock-up, although you can't really mock up a poof, unless you did like three and made one, like you'd have to go one poof and two poofs, and then you could mock that up.
Mm-hmm.
But then not cut your poof, just kind of let it hang, and then see what you like all your materials to be cut for. Because the last thing you want to do is have a bunch of ribbons cut or deco mesh curls cut that are too long or they're too short and you can't use them for anything. There's that one. I have one in the middle. Right in here. And it was funny, even when we did the one that we did Sunday with the group, we kept changing stuff on it. Like, I wasn't completely sold on everything. I kind of had an idea of what I wanted, but I didn't mock up. And that was the first thing someone called me on. They were like, what's your mock up look like? I was like, I didn't do one. Maybe that would have been like the good thing to do. And then I wouldn't have cut all my ribbon. I'll use it somewhere else, but I was like.
But you usually do.
Yeah. Well, yes and no. Unless I completely change my mind and go, okay, I don't like the way that looks now in a larger scale. Mm-hmm. Then I can change it. And I'm almost done. I have two more to go. And I think I only have like, I think I'll have two spares left. And I think one of those was from, I pulled my mock apart a little bit. Because most of the time when I count my mock-ups too.
So Carolyn asked if you could just talk a little bit louder.
Absolutely. Sometimes I just get into my own zone and I just start working. Do you know before I did my very first live, nobody was home. Kaylee was at work. Steve was on a trip, and I was just here by myself, and I was like, after watching all the other people I had watched do read tutorials, I just sat here and I just role-played my own. Okay, everybody, we're sitting here cutting, and it's down to 10 inches. So, trying to help myself get over the fear of doing my own. Okay, so that's what it looks like with all the ribbons in, where we can add ribbon to it. So again, I put the yellow in the blues, pipe cleaners, and then I put the yellow with blues, and blue with the yellows. Yes, so that's what that looks like. And then now I'm gonna just put a couple of these in, not a lot because I want to add some of my floral. And people always ask me, how long are you cutting your tubes to? I don't really have a measurement. It's just more gauged. I'm doing a 3-loop. So this is 21 inches. And what it is I just sit here and loop them. So make one loop, two loops, three loops. And then I would take this and put this in the one with the yellow.
And no rhyme or reason on the three.
Sometimes I like three, sometimes I like four. When we were doing the St. Patrick's Day one, I did three on all of them except one, and then I made it one that was a four, so it would be like a four-leaf clover. So I was hoping that customer would catch on to that. I don't think they did. So it's just, what is that, like wreath maker's fun?
Yeah.
So again, it's just all one big huge piece, and I got these. They came in a bag at the Dollar Tree. Right now, because their Easter stuff's out, so they're just a dollar for the blue, and it's dollar for the green, and they have it in...
Dollar for the yellow.
Yellow, yeah. I always think it's lime green. They have it in pink and green, yellow, and blue. So if you see it...
That one's kind of messed up. You might want to... Right there.
Oh, sure. They just fold.
Yeah, sometimes they fold wrong.
So, we'll take this and go. Here's one. Two, three, and then I just cut them. And then I stick it inside the little bow ties. So I put the yellow on top of the blue, and the blue on top of the yellow.
And once again, you can get that from Dollar Tree.
Mm-hmm. There's a dollar bag dollar if you bag. Can get them. Yep. And
they have all sorts of spring colors, I think, too. They have purple.
No purple.
No purple? I thought they did.
Blue, pink, yellow, and green. Yeah. And I was trying to think, they had green. So I bought the green today. And I think I managed to find pink at another store. And I'll grab, since they're only a dollar, I'll grab like five of each color if they have that many for me to take. Because I'll use them somewhere else. I might use this at Christmas time to do kind of like a frozen wreath, just something with blues. This I'll probably use in a summer wreath, like summer lemonade, sunflowers, and the green is obviously, you know, you can use that no problem. Where'd you go?
I was looking to see what the colors you had.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so I'm just going to do like every other one, and then I'll go back in and add some floral. So now, since I'm doing this, I can cut at the same time. When I get down to the end, usually I will always advise don't cut until the very, very end. Because that way, if you don't like the look, you can unravel it, take it apart,
change out your colors. Don't cut your pipe cleaners.
What do you mean?
Don't cut your pipe cleaners until the very end.
Yeah. Right. But I kind of know that this is like where I want it to end. So that's what it's going to look like there. And then there's the blue. So I'll probably add a blue one there. And we taught the group on Sunday how to add floral to a deckle mesh wreath, which is really easy. And it's really nice because the deckle mesh acts like a net and will hold both your floral to the deco mesh really nice. So I'm just cutting these. I twist them about 5 times at the very end, and then I'll take my pipe cleaner and bend it back behind the ribbon. Just like so, yellow. So I'm just making my 3 little loops.
I don't know, has anybody made another wreath from Jane's rain sign before? I haven't seen one. Her umbrella sign?
I'm trying to think, where did I get that from?
Well, you got it from Jane's front door to call.
Well, yeah.
I don't think anybody has made one yet.
No, because it's funny, because you look at it and you go, okay, what holiday would that go for? I have it for a housewarming gift. It'd be really nice for a housewarming gift. It'd be really nice to give to someone going through a really tough time. Somebody who needs a little bit of cheer.
Could use it for a baby shower, believe it or not.
Yeah, you could. I don't think I would add pink to it.
Depends on if it was a boy or a girl.
No, but you could go with just these general colors. Yeah. I think the one that we did, the Easter one, we said it could have been a gender reveal one.
Yeah.
That's blue. That's blue. Here's my yellow. But yeah, we thought, wouldn't that be cool if you had, like, instead of putting the sign in the middle, you could have just did all blue, pink and blues, and then just have something in the middle that you could pop that would be a gender reveal.
Yeah, Jane said she hasn't seen anybody do it with that sign yet.
Jane at Jane's Front Door Decor?
Yeah.
Oh.
And then Shirley said, my ribbons don't always stay where I want them, even though I put them in tightly.
What do you mean? What happens to them? Do they slide around? Do they pull out?
Yeah, you really have to twist them in tight.
And I know what she's saying, because there's some times where I go to twist it and my ribbon almost like twists on itself and my pipe cleaner kind of goes top and bottom of the ribbon. So I just have to take it, and when I'm doing it, and I'll show you like what I'm doing here. Inside my pipe cleaners, I'm holding my ribbon in there till I get my pipe cleaners on both sides, like you're tying a shoe, and then I just cross it. Because if I was to let it go, then it would spin on itself. If that makes sense.
I think the key thing, too, is when you're doing the twist ties on the pipe cleaners, every time you put the first ruffle deco mesh in, and then you add the curl in, and then you add the ribbon in, you have to keep twisting it the same way, same direction.
Well, yeah. We have issues because sometimes Steve will help me, and he's left-handed.
Yeah.
So he'll twist them one way and I twist them the other. And then when I go to lay my ribbon in, I'm untwisting whatever deco mesh was in there. Yeah. So it's like, oh, the working with a lefty.
Yeah, she always said she just feels like she has to adjust them several times.
You will. Like, I don't even... Most of the time when I'm doing my wreath, I don't even fluff my bows till the very, very, very end. Otherwise, I would fluff them as I put them in. I'd fluff them as I put something else in on top of them. I'd fluff them just before I would take my pictures. And the nice thing about the wired ribbons is you can kind of pull them through your fingers and they kind of curl.
And then so. Susan said you could just use the wreath for April showers.
Yeah, you could.
Yeah.
That's what I said. It's kind of that transitional wreath. It's kind of spring into summer. If you add the floral, it could be a little bit of Mother's Day.
But who says you need a holiday to put a wreath on your door?
Well, no, you don't. You can go with an all seasonal one.
But they'd be great up in Washington and Oregon. Northern states that get a lot of rain.
I'm just trying to find my yellow that I haven't already put a ribbon in it. We're almost done, babe.
Florida gets a ton of rain?
Yeah. Places where it's rainy. I think right now there's some places that have had way too much rain and they're like over the rain now. While everybody else is like, we have all of our spring flowers out and everything is blooming. I've got one, two, I think three more of these to go, and then we can add our floral.
And then Shirley said your curls are nice and uniform also. She likes that.
They are?
They look like they're all the same thickness. And.
Oh, yeah. I think you just get into the groove and do it. And I like mine a little bit tighter initially when I'm starting, so that when I put them in, they're going to uncurl just a smidge. But at least they'll be tight and then they can unroll just a little. I think we call them what? Cannoli rolls?
Yeah. Jackie was doing a really good job at curling them once she got the hang of it.
Yeah, she did. They're not that hard. Like she said, the thing that she noticed is that sometimes you have to pinch them, like fold it at first to get it going. Which is sometimes what I do. It depends on the quality of the deco mesh. Some just rolls easier than others.
Cheryl, where are we as far as the state? We're in Southern California, Cheryl. But we're kind of in a high desert.
We look out over everybody else in Southern California.
Yeah, we're like east northeast of Los Angeles. So we rarely get any rain.
Oh, and I put the wrong color. I put blue on blue. I was like, what looks odd?
Catherine said they're still getting snow.
See? Where are you at, Catherine? That you're still getting snow? Probably on the East Coast. Because I know that they just got hit with another nor'easter. And it dropped like another foot of snow. Twist, twist, twist.
Well, when I was flying back from Portland, though, there's a lot of snow in the mountains now.
Mountains... Not our local mountains, right?
No, the Sierras on the way down.
Oh, I was going to say, our local mountains hardly have anything, which is really sad.
She said NEPA.
Okay, yellow gets blue. Hey, here's where that one can go.
So Laura said she's had close to 9 inches of rain in the last couple days.
You know, the people in California would love that rain. This is going to be a really bad year. Mark my words, the summer for California is just going to be a nightmare. Wait till we get our Santa Anas that kick in. And the fact that we haven't had any winter this year. We're probably going to be under a mandatory drought. Well, we are right now. We can only water, depends on the ending number in our house address. We can only water like every other day. Yes,
Shirley says she's at 8.5 inches in New Jersey this week.
God.
And then Catherine said she's in Scranton, Wilkes, Pennsylvania.
Uh-huh.
And then Gloria Maddock must be out where we are. And she says no snow, sick of it.
No snow?
Mm-hmm.
Well, why would she be out in our area if she said that she's sick of the snow?
She said no snow, sick of it.
Yeah, no rain. That's what I'm... Our climate has changed so much. I mean, one of the things that we used to like about living here was we had desert thunderstorms in the summer. That was so amazing to watch.
Yeah.
And now we don't have those at all anymore.
Oh, so Catherine said NEPA, she's near the Poconos.
Oh, by the Pocono racetrack. You know where that's at.
Yep.
He knows that area all too well. think this is the last one. I keep saying that, and then I turn it around and realize, oh, nope, there's another one. Blue.
Oh, Larissa, she said, meant not rain, she has a ton of snow.
Oh. Okay. I think there's one. Just one. I missed. Okay, so it's yellow. So I put these in every single one that I could see.
You alternated colors.
Yeah, I put the, if it was a yellow ribbon, I put a blue little flex tube on. And if it's a blue ribbon, I put the yellow on. So it just went completely opposite of that. Just to kind of tie those in. And I've been able to cut all my twist ties off. What are you retrieving from the floor?
Oh, I just dropped a couple pipe cleaners.
Oh. So let me move this stuff to the side. Just like this. Okay, let me show you what this looks like. So it's the right side up.
Peggy said there's places by her, Catherine and Donna, says they haven't had power for 10 days.
What?
In northeast Pennsylvania.
Yeah. How's that possible? You guys must be running off of generators then. Oop, forgot this twist tie. These must have been the first ones I did. Because I could cut them all off. Is there something at the door?
Yeah.
We have an alarm system that tells us there's activity in the front of our house. Okay. So let me hold this up and show you guys what you think. What do you think, babe? Oh, those are my business cards.
Yeah. Pretty. I think you need to move some coils around because it's kind of getting in the way of the sign a little bit.
Yeah. But I also wanted to incorporate a bow, and I'm thinking right here, like a bow. What do you guys think? It just seems flat there, like there's nothing, like a nice blue.
What do you guys think? Yes, bow?
I can show you how to do a bow real quick, and then we're pretty much done.
Didn't you want to put
some
florals
in? Oh yeah,
it's
gonna add florals. Duh. Okay. Never mind. Thank you for being here. So, what I do with our tulips is, these are tulips that you get at Michael's. I'm sure you guys have seen these everywhere because everyone's making tulip wreaths. These are $2 a bunch. And you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stems that you can work with. So I usually pull.
So Cheryl, Tammy, Kathy, and Catherine said yes, bow.
Yes, bow. See? I know. We need a bow. It needs a bow. But it also needs some floral, too. So what I'm doing is kind of looking
your
to see.
On?
Huh? Yeah, my glue gun's on. I have it sitting on the little table right here. But I'm just looking. I'm playing. Seeing what I want to add. So what I do, because I didn't do it in my other group, we just glued as we went. I was feeling confident then.
You're still mocking it up?
Yeah. I'm just kind of looking at where I want these to go. Not there. Not there. I'm just kind of laying them in. Just poofing and fluffing. So I'm always pushing my greenery to the top because it sits so far down. And you're not going to glue that much in there. Go inside. So I might want to just add the floral to the sign.
Yeah, you could do that in the opposite little corner and then put the bow on the other opposite corner.
That'd
be
one?
Pretty. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that one needs a bow. It's like, it's talking to me and telling me, I need a bow. I need something.
Do your wreaths talk to you, ladies?
Yeah, they do. They know. Our wreaths talk to us.
Sure. Karen and Peggy both said yes, bow too. So.
See.
It's unanimous.
That's gonna be a bow. But I am adding some tulips around our sign just to make it more cherry. And I always look for my tulips that have at least three on. Some only have two. Some of them don't look so pretty. Like that one. So I'm gonna steal them from my other one. So I'm just looking for ones that look really nice. Like, because sometimes they get smushed sitting in Michael's bins.
Hey, Robin joined us a little late, but it's awesome.
Welcome,
she's from
Robin.
Missouri. She said, loving your colors.
Nice to have you join us.
Yeah, you can always go back and watch the replay once we finish up, and we should be done here in just a little bit.
It won't take me that long to make a bow. But what do you guys think so far of the floral? Do you like that?
You guys like it? And then Shorty Mac just joined too. Said, hey guys.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking at some of these. Again, I'm gonna move everything up. I don't think I want that one quite that tall.
I'm telling you, you're adding tulips and daisies.
He's going off the Bruce Almighty reference when he brought Jennifer Aniston his version of tulips and daisies, and he called them ta-daisies.
It's the ta-daisy.
That's why he keeps saying that.
It's the ta-daisy wreath.
I'm doing tulips and roses. Make this guy go to the back. Maybe add just a little pop of daisies to tie in. And these ones came from Dollar Tree, and they have little butterflies on them too, but I don't want a butterfly in there. I want the other yellow and blue. We'll cut this one off and just add that little bit of yellow floral to it. There we go. It's funny how the yellow, the blue just elevates itself higher. I don't want it to cover the sign, but I'm just placing for now where I want it to go. Going behind to the outside. Maybe one more. Last one.
You guys like it? Yeah, it looks good.
You like it like that?
Are you just going to do a small bow? Probably.
I might just surprise you and do a gargantuan bow. No, I would not do big. Okay, so when you're gluing into deco mesh, you're just going to load the end of your stem pretty heavily. So I have these little silicone mats that I got from Amazon that allow me to catch all the glue. So I don't glue my mat. And then when it dries, it just peels right off of my silicone mat.
And the deco mesh acts as kind of a netting that holds the glue.
It does. And I'm just positioning my rhythm where I wanted it to go. Let's see, I have these that will intermix with these guys.
And be generous with the glue.
Yes, very generous with the glue. So I'm just spinning it around the end of my...
Sharon and Shorty said, very pretty.
Thank you. And I like the way the greenery just kind of adds just the right color. Adds just a touch of green without being like, ooh, look at me. Those two. We glued that one. So now I'm doing these. So I'm doing real world, like, for for you guys. A lot of people say, I don't know where to put my flowers. What do I do? Should I put my flowers where they need to go first? Absolutely.
Oh, sorry about that, Tammy. She says she's going to finish watching the video later. She said the burn is kind of making her feel bad.
Oh, sorry, Tammy. We'll be praying for you that you feel
better.
Take it
easy, Tammy. Get some rest and have a good weekend.
Okay. We will put this.
When Catherine said her iPad froze, she will watch a replay. Good night. Good night, Catherine.
Night. Thanks for joining us, guys. While you guys are waiting for me to finish doing these last, I think I have like 2 stems left to do. Can you guys just do me a favor and like this post? If you're a first-time viewer, if you like and follow my page, when I go live on Sundays and Fridays at 5, you'll get notified that I am online, so you guys shouldn't miss out on my lives. And then if you share the video, like how everyone's signing off right now, if they share it, it's just going to be on their page. They're not going to have to go dig for it in the midst of my page.
Yeah, because it's about 9:40 on the East Coast.
Yeah. I know, it's getting late. These ones are the last ones. Last ones, then I'll throw down a bow real quick. And then we're done. So these just add.
No, this will probably be the April showers wreath, right?
What?
The naming of this wreath.
Yeah, it's called. I named it April showers. Well, just because April showers bring May flowers.
Yeah.
And then I'll, of course, fuss through that. So this is what it looks like with them all glued in. And then I'll show you guys how to do a quick bow.
Very pretty.
So we're gonna just make one for here. So about the size of my hand with some, maybe a little bit of tail. So I'm going to use the Bodabra.
Bonita liked and shared earlier. Thank you, Bonita.
Thank you very much for doing that.
And Sue said, very pretty.
See, and I only had these left of my mock, but that's okay.
Is this one up on your Etsy store?
Yeah, it is. I do, what do they call them? Space holders. So if people like it, they can go look. It won't have this picture because obviously I haven't designed it. It just has a Facebook Live on it. This is the wreath we're making in our Facebook Live right now.
Yep, and I pinned it at the bottom so you can check out our shop and from the pin that I put on the bottom of the post.
I'm just bending that one. Okay, so I'm moving that to the side. Okay, remember what I told you guys about the glue on the silicone mat? So like when it was all dripping, this is what the silicone mat allows you to do, is just pick up your glue. And if you have a glue skillet, you just take this and you throw it back in your glue skillet and it'll remelt. So really nothing's wasted except what is left on the green stems. So let me grab my ribbon. I'm gonna do a 2.5 on the bottom, and then I'm gonna do the yellow gingham on the top. So to start this, dovetail your end. So I'm going to do a 4-loop bow on the bottom and then a 4-loop smaller bow with a yellow on top. So to load the Bodabra.
Watch your tail. Watch your dovetail.
Oh.
Looks like it didn't fold right.
How sad. We will just re-cut him. I wonder why that happened like that. There we go.
There you go.
Thanks for a good catch. Okay, so we load it in the Bodabra.
Do you want the good side down?
No. Because I'm doing it, I'm building the bow that a way that I want to see it. So I'm going to twist. So it's face down on this side, and then I twist it so the right side is face down. And I'm just trying to uncurl it. I'm going to bring it up. And then I'm going to twist right here. Push it back down. And that automatically puts the right side down where I need it to be. So now we're face down again. And then I try to do this so that I don't have to move it like I'm used to doing. So here's my loop. Again, loops on the right side of my material is on the outside. So I'm going to twist. So so that the right side is now face down as it goes in. And I'm gonna make sure my loops are the same size and do the same thing again, because I said I wanted a four loop bow at the bottom. So it's gonna be two on one side and two on the other. Twist, put it back in the bodabra. And obviously you guys can see this side's a little longer, so you can just kind of pull that in until your bows are even. And then it's wrong side is on the inside, right side's on the out. Twist, put it in. Make sure these are the same. And then because I have a tail on this side, I want to make sure that I'm going to have a tail on this side. So I'm just going to eyeball it, because if I need to, I can always cut one side more than the other. So edges together, cut on the fold. There's my dovetail. So there's the bottom. Put that there and grab a big yellow. So here's our yellow. Start with the dovetail. Cut. Since our tail's here, we have to start with the tail over here.
Barb Auden said the bodabra is the best thing she's ever owned.
And it's funny because when I do this, I would have already had the bow done and on there, but I'm just doing it really slow. And normally what I do is what I'm doing right now, I just turn it, because I like to have my bows always, I don't know, this side as I'm making them. It's just my preference. So this ribbon does not have a right or wrong side, but the process is still the same. So you make your loop, you twist it, you push it back in. Make sure your loops are about the same size.
You're going a little bit shorter on the yellow.
Yes, because this is my top.
Yeah.
So a little bit shorter on the yellow because I'm going to the top. So.
Yes, the bodabra has been awesome.
Twist. Everybody in my family can use it. Everybody can use it here. It's just easy. It's just loop, twist, push it down, loop, twist, push it down. And then you can sit here. It's also great for scraps of leftover ribbon, like these are too short, but if you have like 14 or 17 inch pieces, you could just lay those in and make two loops and have a little tail and just keep going with all your leftover pieces of ribbon.
There's a Mithas that looks great, love the mesh wreaths. And then Melissa said, hey y'all.
Hi Melissa.
She said she just got her bodabra and she loves it.
I love it.
And there's Beth said, hey from Maryland, so we got some late comers, but thanks for joining.
And so now, like I said, it's a two bow. I'm looking for the other little bit of blue that I had in the half inch blue. Is it over there?
Yeah, it's over there.
It is? Half? Oh, yeah. So let me see how much of this I have left. This is how much of the little one I have. Maybe I might have enough to do two loops on the very top and tie that. So this is what I was saying, you can do leftover ribbon.
Robin asked, how do you feel about the bodabra versus the probo?
I'm intimidated by the probo because it's an awful lot to learn a bunch of different bows. Like, I've mastered the basic bow, but it's the whole concept of the wires and the looping and keeping my ribbon straight. And here, it's just easier. I can stop when I want to and go get something to drink and come back. I mean, I guess you could do that with the probo too. It's just really intimidating for me.
It just takes a lot of practice.
Yeah.
That's really.
So I'm gonna kind of see if I have enough to make a two. I may or may not. So I'm trying to use it the last of my ribbon.
Doesn't look like it.
Have faith. Have faith, babe. Have faith. Ha ha.
Oh, you're just going to do one on each side?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay.
Sorry, two loops, meaning one on each side. So yes, I did have enough. So see, that's what it's great for, is piecing together all your leftovers. And I've done that before in a lot of leftover bows. Now I need pipe cleaner. And I want blue. Blue. Not green. So, there was a little piece. Some of you may not know what this piece is for in your Bodabra. It goes in the middle like so, and it puts a better pinch in all your layers. Especially when you're working with thick ribbon like the burlap ribbon. So this way, when you go to pull it out, kind of shake it, it like holds everything together in your perfect sandwich. And then I just take a pipe cleaner, try to make it as accurate as I can, and just twist it. And just twist it like so, and then your bow's all done. And then you can put it on, and I fluff it after I put it on.
Melissa said, yes, I wondered what that was for.
Yeah, I know.
And then Ruby said, have you watched the YouTube videos on the Pro Bow?
Yes.
Yeah, we've watched them. In fact, Kat's even done a kind of a tutorial on the Pro Bow.
The basic one.
The basic one, right.
Yeah. I was like, let's do it together. Let's not be intimidated by the Pro Bow. We can do this. Because Steve bought it for me for Christmas, but I never used it. I was like, I'm just too scared. Because I'd watch people like Damon or even Regina or some of the other wreath makers. And I was like, that's just too much for me. Yeah. I'm never going to master that.
Robin said, I haven't made a wreath yet.
Okay.
Been obsessed with watching lives for about 2 weeks and bought tons of ribbon and mesh. She said, LOL, needs to get started.
Yeah, you do.
Just do it.
Just jump in. You know, every wreath you do will get better than the wreath you did before. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking my blues and I'm pulling my blues apart. And I don't want it to cover my sign. So I want my sign to be prevalent, just like so.
Robin, I have made several wreaths with Kat.
He has. So he can do it. You can do it. Kaylee can do it. Kaylee wants to be on one of our lives.
I haven't used a Pro Bow yet, but I'm good with the Bodabra.
You would not be afraid to dig in there, though, and use it, right? Right?
Yeah, no, not at all.
You would challenge yourself to that. I refuse to let something intimidate me that much that I would be afraid to use it.
Yep, and then Kathy Ranishan said, me too, Robin, making my first one tomorrow. Good for you, Kathy.
Yeah, I want to see pictures.
Yeah, post, send us some
come
pictures.
Come back and post pictures on my page. You guys can post stuff on here.
Here's the opposite. Liz says, I use my Pro Bow and I'm intimidated by the Bodabra. She's never used it.
Okay. We seriously need to just... We did one... Where we just did, what did we do? We did the Pro Bow.
You did the dog.
We did the dog paw print once because we just made bows for the dog paw print race. So we did the, what did we do? We made two bows with the Bodabra and got people really fluent with using that. And then we all did the Pro Bow, the basic bow, all together. And really, the thing I like about the Pro Bow is your bows are precise. All the loops are the same. The guesswork's taken out of it. But like I said, I've been using this for 7 months now. Just because for the first time the Pro Bow was kind of out of my price range for me initially. So I'm just fluffing my ribbons.
So this is the tutorial she did where she did the Pro Bow
with the
middle.
Pro Bow in the middle.
And then she used the Bodabra on the outside.
Yeah. So that's what that looks like. And I like it. I just have to get used to the different sizes because it's based on rows like A, B, C, D. And I like being able to format mine to go whatever I want. So if I want smaller loops at the top, then I guess I would have to watch more Pro Bow tutorials.
Robin says you ordered the Pro Bow and have watched demo. She's going to try it first. Good for you. Do it.
I know. Just jump in there and do it, right?
And the good thing is it's a bow, right? If it doesn't come out,
if it doesn't
great,
come out,
redo it.
Exactly. That's what I always say. If it doesn't come out the way you wanted to, even the Bodabra, just pull it all apart. Start all over again. So I am just fluffing. And I don't want it to completely cover my sign. So I'm just kind of moving it to the side. And I don't want it to cover the flowers I just put in. Let me move my little coils so they're out of the way. Because Steve is picky. He's like, it's covering the sign.
Sorry guys, I'm too tall.
Cheryl said she couldn't see the bows.
Oh. You have to
there
go below.
There you go.
So, Pro Bow.
Center one was Pro Bow.
These are Bow Dapra.
And the other ones were the Bow Dapra.
Yeah, you can't really tell. It's just this one's more precise.
The Pro Bow, you have a lot of loops in the Pro Bow.
It depends. You can make it a lot of loops or just a few loops, depending upon how many little sticks you go around.
Yep.
So, okay. You and your... And I'm just fluffing one last time because I really don't want to cover my sign. But I need to fluff all my loops out too. Okay. I think it's going to be where I want it to be. And that's a loop.
Okay. So
I'm flipping it. I just was moving all the curls so you can see what it looks like. This is what it looks like.
There you go.
Now that we are done. So we added some floral. And then here's our bow. And it goes all the way to the side. And then the height.
It's about 6 inches.
Yeah. Maybe. But it would all pack really nice. Your bows would be smashed, so you would just tell the customer to basically just take their fingers, run them through the loops, kind of pull up on your bows, fluff out your ribbon tails, whichever way you want.
You
want
to hold it up again? There you go.
Mm-hmm. Is that the right way?
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
That's what it looks like.
Awesome.
And we are technically done.
Yep.
So this is our April showers wreath. So... if you guys have any questions, the replay will be posted exactly after this video. If you want to join my private group, we have our own private group. It's a much smaller group. I think there's only 30 people in the group.
Yeah.
And we get together on Wednesday nights and we make something amazing. You guys get my undivided attention. You can email me, you can message me regarding help with anything. So if you want to do that, that's on my Etsy store as well. It's just $10 a month to be in the private group and get more consolidated,
slower
training, I guess.
Yep.
All right, guys.
Plus a full list of everything that you use and where you get it from.
Yeah, that's the big perk that a lot of my members like is the additional video. And then they get materials list to both the main group, like today. They'll get a materials list for everything, so they'll get the SKUs, where I got it from, and what all the measurements were. Like, you need to cut 9 10-inch blue or 9 10-inch yellow, so it's all there. Plus all the website links, too. All right, guys. Well, have a great weekend. I will be back on Sunday. We're moving it an hour earlier. So you guys said you didn't want it at 6. You wanted to keep it all consistent at 5. So I will see you Sunday night live at 5. So we'll work on something then. Bye guys, have a great weekend.